What exactly are RAW files? They're uncompressed digital image files, meaning they retain all the original data from the camera sensor. So the image sizes are larger compared to like JPEG, which are compressed format. So today we're going to see how these RAW files can be edited in Snapseed app, which is free for Android and iOS. Hey all, if you're not familiar with me, this is Nagesh from the channel NavEdits. RAW images have a number of different formats, depends on the camera manufacturer. The most common format is the DNG format, and Snapseed supports RAW files of any device, including your phones that can capture DNG. If by chance your camera doesn't capture in DNG format, there are tools which convert these RAW files into DNG format. I will leave some links for these in the video description if you want to check them out. You can also capture photos in RAW DNG format in most of the phones these days. There are two ways to open DNG files in Snapseed. You can share the image directly from the gallery to Snapseed, or you can open the image directly from the Snapseed app itself. After opening the image in Snapseed, it directly takes it to this screen with two menu items you can see at the bottom. This is the develop menu, and next is the white balance with the presets. We will start with the develop menu. This menu is exclusively available only while editing RAW files. These are the sliders available in the develop menu. Exposure increases or decreases the overall brightness. Drag left or right to do it. In this case, I don't want to alter the exposure. You can double tap to reset the value. I'm going to work with highlights and shadows to alter the brightness. Highlights adjust the brightness of the brightest areas of the image. Here, I'm going to lower it to make the brightest areas darker. This also brings out the details in the overexposed areas like the sky in this image. Increasing the shadows now. This affects the darkest areas of the image, bringing out the brightness on the darker parts here. Basically, we have made the image look flat with more details to work with now. Adding contrast just a little. Structure uses a unique algorithm to bring out the texture of the objects without affecting the edges of the objects. Increasing it adds more details to the image. One of the strong features of Snapseed, in my opinion. Saturation increases the intensity of the color. Adding more saturation to the image to make it look more colorful. I won't alter the temperature or tint for now. Temperature adjusts the balance between cool blue tones and warm yellow tones. Tint adjusts the balance between green and magenta tones. I'm gonna apply this. We can always come back to this menu if you want to alter these later. From here, we can try any of these menus and take the image to next level. First, I will use the rotate tool to straighten the image a bit. This auto straightens the image instantly without us needing to do any manual adjustments. Next, I'm gonna use crop tool to manually crop the image to make the composition better. Now to more advanced tools, starting with the selective filters first. We can make some precise selections based on color with selective filters. I'll start by adding one on this golden part around here. There are some areas in the sky with slightly golden color, so we'll pinch down the selection a bit. Here, swiping vertically gives four options to tune these areas. First, sliding towards right to increase the brightness. We'll leave the contrast as it is. Adding a lot of color to pop the golden colors by increasing the saturation. Tapping on it gives more options. We'll copy this and place it on the other parts to give the image more pop. Making sure to move and place them on the golden color here. Adding a couple more on these white structures to add more details by increasing only structure. This is the before and after. Already looking a lot different from the original image. Now, I will darken the image in some areas to make the image more interesting. In curves, dragging the top point of the curves, which mainly affects the brighter areas, a bit down to make the overall image darker. Now, we need to go to the masking screen. Clicking on the stacks icon, then view edits. Here, you find the list of all the edits done. Tapping on the last curves effect and choosing the brush option. Here, with the effect hidden and brush value set at 100, I'm going to zoom out and brush on the image to make those parts darker. You can toggle the eye icon to see where the effect is added. Making the right part of the sky and the image more dark. The reason why I'm doing this is to create more light around the left part, which I will do shortly. We'll apply this effect first. Now coming back and adding couple more selective filters. One here in the sky to make that part a bit darker. This is another way to make the sky more dark. Copying and pasting it here. Decreasing the structure to make those parts more smoother. One selective filter here on the left part where I will increase the brightness a lot. Also the saturation to create a light source. Also adding one on the red fabric of the lady to make it pop. Adding more brightness and color, which gives unique pop to the image. Next, I'm going to tune contrast a bit with curves, just lifting the blacks a little and darkening the midtones a bit. Next, to create a big light source, I'm going to lift the blacks to get more white into the image. Also by bringing the blue curve down, adding yellows to the image, also adding reds using the red curve. After applying this, going to the masking screen and applying this effect only around the left part to create a fake light source, which gives the image more interesting look. We'll add another curves effect to make it more dark. Creating a sort of vignette around the right areas of the image. Now, going to the white balance menu, we'll increase the temperature to make the image more warmer, which in this case gives this striking, unique golden colors to the image. Here you can see the changes after each effect applied and the final result. And also really appreciate these for supporting my channel by subscribing for the membership. Hope you found the video useful and subscribe for more. See you all in my next video. Thank you.